What up, EDS Squad? Long time no see. It's your boy Eli, and I'm back with a new series called Underrated. But before I get into this new series, please like this video, comment down below, hit that share button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell. We're on the road to 100 subs. We're almost there, we're almost there. With that being said, let's get into Underrated.
And if real is the issue, then they all artificial. And I can never diss you, but I will dismiss you straight to your face. Nah, I ain't got no manners, and these bros ain't got no standards. That's why he can't stand you. Always got your hand out for a handout. Can't stand on your own too. How you gonna stand out? I bet you missed the point. What a disappointment. Like I missed the point. Man, never indirect, but your intellect without introspect is so incorrect. Goddamn. Now that's disrespectful. But when you
So today, episode one of Underrated, which will be a monthly series where I pick one artist that I think should be booming in the music business today, but for unseen and and all the craziness that comes with the music business, this is why I think they're not in the mainstream talk. Today, I'm going to be doing my girl, KeKe Palmer. Oh my goodness, when you talk about KeKe, I gotta talk about KeKe all day, because people that know me know that I love KeKe from her. I loved her ever since I first saw her, but we're gonna get into, we're gonna get her acting a little bit, but mostly this series will be about the music and all that stuff. But KeKe Palmer is a triple threat. She's an actress, she's a singer, and she's a dancer, so you know. Gotta cover all the bases, at least. So let's get into this. So, KeKe Palmer, real name, Lauren Kiana Palmer. She was born She was born August 23rd, 1993 in Harvey, Illinois. That's right by Chicago area, I believe. KeKe has been in the business since 2004, so she's a vet in the game at this point. Like, she's on that veteran status. She's been in the game more than 10 years, so she on that vet. She on that. But no, for real. We all remember seeing her, or I remember seeing her. I don't know if you guys are old enough, or if you guys haven't seen, which I don't think in 2018 you wouldn't have seen Barbershop 2, where KeKe Palmer makes her acting debut. She was Queen Latifah's character's niece, and we all know how, you know, that little attitude, I'ma tell my auntie. We already know, KeKe came onto this scene very, you know. But after Barbershop 2, she did Aquila and the Bee, which was obviously her first breakout role. It was her first starring role. She did an amazing job in that movie. Also, in 2006, she also did Madea's Family Reunion. Remember when Madea tore that ass up? You know, because she was being disrespectful. Look, if you touch me, I'm going to call 911. then in 2008, she did The Long Shot. 2009, she did Shrink. And 2012, she did Joyful Noise, just to name a few acting roles. She also did TV movies, Jump In, which was, you know, one of my favorite movies in my childhood. That's when she started with Corbin Blue from High School Musical. She also did Rags in 2012. In TV, she did she was True Jackson VP, which is a fun fact that she made $20,000 per episode, which means that she was the fourth highest paid child actor at the time. She also did Scream Queens, and she currently recurs sometimes on Star. Another fun fact, she did the Runaway Love video, Runaway Love by Ludacris. So let's get into her work. Let's get into her albums. Let's get into her EPs and all that good jazz. So her first album was released September 18th, 2007 through Atlantic Records. It was called So Uncool. Personally, Atlantic needed to get smacked 20 billion times because there was no promo. There was no, like, and if there was promo, like, 2007, I'm trying to think. She was Nickelodeon doing all that stuff. There was no promo. Like, she didn't even, like, they didn't even promote her as a childhood singer. Like, promoting her for, you know, through Disney Channel, through Nickelodeon, through the kids' TV shows or the kids' radios. Like, if I did hear a song from KeKe Palmer's first album, I don't remember it. If I did, like the promotion. So one thing that really goes with her being so underrated is that each label she worked with, the promotion was horrible. There either was no promotion, or if there was promotion, it was very lackluster. It debuted number 85 on the Billboard charts, which, I mean, isn't the worst. I mean, honestly, for no promotion and people not really knowing, like, getting your album on the Billboard charts, period, is a blessing in itself. But at the same time, it's just like, So I believe they dropped her after that, which sucks. The music business sucks, because if you don't sell, they're gonna drop you like a bad habit. But she cooled off on music and focused on her acting, but she still, you know, recorded here and there. In January of 2011, she released her first mixtape called Awaken, which spun off a single, The One You Call. Around this time, she also started her YouTube channel. So it was kind of a dope thing to release music and then do a YouTube channel. That way you can put your videos on there, you know, and do all that stuff. So that was a good marketing tool. In 2012, she released her second EP called KeKe Palmer. I mean, it wasn't an EP, excuse me. It was a mixtape called KeKe Palmer. And it spun off two singles, You Got Me featuring Kevin McCall, which was released in July of 2012, and Dance Alone. Again, promotion and all that stuff, like, it wasn't there. So with that being said, like, there's only your hardcore fans that stan you to the day you die are really going to go hard. But as for, like, casual people that you probably could have gotten views, you could have gotten sales from, it wasn't there because the promotion wasn't there. 2013, she did the TLC movie, which we all know she played Chili. Another thing, April of 2014, it was announced that Just KeKe, her first talk show, and a talk show, I think she was, like, the first talk show host, the youngest talk show host to have her own talk show, which is dope. I loved it, Just KeKe. It was a dope show. It really was geared towards teens and early 20-year-olds. It was dope. She really had a lot of good advice and got a lot of good words of wisdom to give to the youth. So I really thought that was a good project, and it was really dope. I believe Just KeKe premiered June 30th of 2014. And in August of 2015, she signed with Universal music group, and she signed a deal with Island Records. Which brings me to what I'm gonna say next. The first single that she dropped from that new record label, Island Records, was I Don't Belong to You, and that was released on October 25th of 2015. Again, no promotion. If there was promotion, it was very lackluster. I don't know. Like, that's the main thing with KeKe, because she has it. She can sing her ass off. She can dance her ass off. Like, and her music is not bad. Like, it'd be one thing if her music was bad and, like, people just wasn't messing with it because it was bad music. Like, her music is good, so it's like the promotion just wasn't there. Her second single, Enemies, featuring Jeremiah, was released on March 4th, 2016. That's when I first... Because, you know, I always loved KeKe, but I'm not going to lie to you guys. I did not hear none of her music until Enemies. I didn't get onto KeKe Palmer's music until Enemies. Because I knew KeKe Palmer did music here and there. But mostly I thought she did music through her movies and through that. Like, she did with soundtracks and stuff like that. But when I first found out that she actually does this music thing was when I first heard Enemies. And I loved it, Enemies. It was a very good pop record. Amy, a lot of pop tees. The video was outstanding. It was a concept. It was a theme, which I live for. When you can give me a concept and a theme, I live for you. I thought this song should have been bigger than it was. It was sent to radio. It just didn't, you know, do what it was supposed to do. Honestly, for me, the promotion just wasn't there. That's all I can say, because it sounds, the song, I'm not going to try to drag her, it sounded like other songs, but at the same time, it was KeKe Palmer's song, and it was KeKe Palmer's style, so, like, I don't get why it didn't do what it did, but honestly, I have to go with promotion. That's the big thing with, you know, promotion. Later that year, November 4th, 2016, she released her first EP through Island Records called Lauren, wait, KeKe Palmer released Lauren, I remember this like it was yesterday, because I was following her heavy around that time, and she was like, okay, I'm about to release this EP, it's called Lauren, this and the third, this is some of my best music that I made thus far. She's been working right hand with, oh my gosh, I know his name, and I'm probably going to put it at the bottom, because I'm having a brain fart, but I know his name. She was working with him, right, like, they was making music like crazy. She was so excited to release it, this and the third. But when Lauren released, she also released a visual to it, and it was like a visual movie. It kind of gave me it wasn't as good as Lemonade and, you know, all that other stuff, but it definitely was, you know, a visual of the songs on her EP. I thought it was dope. I thought the EP was dope. I lived for every single song, which we're gonna get into some of her songs, because again, this is for people to see and for people to like, oh my gosh, I missed this, let me go back and listen. So I'm definitely gonna show you guys some music in this time and the third. I'm almost finished. And after she released her EP did really good. People really loved it. She got a good reviews on it. It did make a couple charts. It didn't make like the Billboard 200. It didn't make none of those, but it did make a couple Billboard charts. Honestly, KeKe, I stand for KeKe. Like, nobody could tell me nothing about KeKe. This EP was everything. Like, it, and mind you, around that time I was going through a lot with relationships and stuff like that, so the songs like Pressure and the songs like Jealous, those and Doubtful, those are like, okay, KeKe, speak to me, talk to me, you talking to me. So I was in my life. But again, that was Lauren. Later on, the next year, she released it, Wind Up, featuring Quavo. I liked it, Wind Up. Again, the promotion was horrible, because I think Wind Up could have did something. I don't think it would have been, like, huge. But I think it could have did something. It could have made some noise. My thing was, I don't know Island Records, because I don't really know a lot of people through Island. Maybe I do know people that signed with Island Records, but KeKe is one of the first people that I know signed with Island Records. So I don't know, like Universal, I don't know, they own a lot of record labels and they have a lot of artists. So it does get to the point where you could be lost in a shuffle. But I think KeKe had good music. She had good marketing because she was doing TV shows. She was doing stuff in between of her doing music. Like she was doing Screen Queens around this time. So it wasn't like they couldn't promote her music and she wasn't hot at the time, because she was. I just don't know. Like, it sucks. She's definitely underrated. A few of her influences was, of course, Ciara, Janet Jackson, Michael Jackson, Mariah Carey, Aaliyah, Brandy, Mary J. Blige, Whitney Houston, R. Kelly, and TLC, just to name a few. She also acknowledged Avril Lavigne and, Gwen Stefani as a couple more of her influences. So, you know, she has a very eclectic taste, and, you know, for me personally, I honestly think, like I told you guys throughout this whole video, that I think promotion was really the downfall of, I won't even say the downfall, because she can always bounce back and she can always have that one hit, but I think the promotion, I think she just needs to step out of the box. She needs to look at other artists and see how they promote their work and how they promote their songs and albums and stuff like that. I think she needs to take a page out of each of those books, even though you, of course, you want to be your own, you want to be your own entity and you want to do your own thing. At the same time, taking tips and taking nuggets from other people and other artists and other things wouldn't hurt. Again, she's definitely talented, so talent is not a problem. Her image is not a problem. I think she just needs to get a nice good body of work, promote it, go everywhere, go to every radio station, everywhere, make sure radios is getting it, make sure radio is playing it. I think that after that, that probably will be, you know, hopefully she can get something that'll stick and pop. Another song she did was Bossy. I think she released that last year. And that was part of The Star. That was another good song. I love Bossy. That's when I'm ghetto ratchet and like ready to twerk and have a good ass time. So you know. So we're going to get into some of her songs. I'm going to play little snippets of some. You guys will also see the videos to these songs as I play them. Then after that, I'm going to have my final words and we'll wrap this up. So again, this is Underrated Episode 1. Let's get into it. So the first song I want to play Doubtful. First of all, the visuals to Doubtful is something serious. KeKe, I'm telling you, and Lauren, KeKe really showed me who she is as an artist, because not only did she grow as an artist, she grew as a person, and you can see that through music, and you can see that through, you know, just watching a person, the little old girl from Barbershop 2, who I'm going to tell my auntie to, you know, get into, excuse me, to Lauren. It's definitely been a transition. It's definitely been a journey. Jealous. This is the song that I bumped every single day, 24/7. This was my anthem. I lived for Jealous. I still live for Jealous. Let's take a look at Jealous.
Don't nobody get respect without earning it. And that's what it's about for me.
Two up, fuck who up. I was sitting in the coupe, watch the bitch pull up. Hate a nigga, think he slick, bitch Rick Ruler. Tell her she tagged me again, she gon' see Trilla. Say that you promise to love me, that's what you. But I see a shorty all on my IG, she just play. Body and abs, so much going for me. I fuck you up, but it's jealousy. Bitch, don't let this TV make you think that you. Southside Mudville, bitch, what's good? What I do? I don't have to twist no fingers, just know I'm good. What I do? You better get beside her, before you catch me in the lineup, tied up in a case I ain't got no business involved. All because you and your feelings that we ain't worried much. Always wanna shed a spotlight. My type, but them boys that got a little straight line. I can still find, hit a bitch the same time, give her that love. Nigga, granted, I let you get up in a panic. Cause I'm moving on, you can't stand it. Fuck a Virgo over one time, I leave you stranded. I'm past it, ain't no hard feelings at all.
You say that you promise to love me, love me. That's what you say. But I see a shorty all on my IG. She just said that. Fighting have so much going for me. I fuck you up, but it's jealousy. Bitch, don't let this TV make you think.
That was Jealous. A splinter of Jealous. The reason why I love that song is, y'all know, like I told y'all before, around that time, I was going through a lot with relationships and stuff like that. I don't know. It's so sad, like, because I'm in a good situation right now, that the other situations I get discombobulated because A, I don't care, and B, like, that's a minute ago. So it's like, I don't even know what situation I was in per se, but I knew I was in a situation where I was not with somebody and I was going through a lot, and Jealous was like my anthem. I live for it. It was definitely one of the songs that really got me looking at KeKe a little different, like, yo, you go in this hard sense? Like, you know, Doubtful is one of those songs where, like I said, it opened up the EP, and it was one of those songs where I was like, okay, it's a dope song, you know, I can see anybody really singing that, no shade, but, like, it's a dope song. But when I heard, when I got to the part of Jealous, it was like, okay, this is something that KeKe really went through, and this is something that she really, like, spitting and telling us. So it was dope. I loved the concept. I loved the video. It was very dope. She went to her hometown and showed the fuck out. She looked amazing. Every look, she looked dope. Her red hair. Oh my. Let's get into the next song, because y'all already know I can stand. I can really, really stand. Another song on her EP, Pressure, which is a dope song. I'm gonna let you guys listen to it, and then, you know, I'll give my little commentary on it. This is Pressure, guys, by KeKe Palmer from the Lauren EP.
Whoa, 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 whoa. So deep, I can't see them right now.
Me again?
I don't think that I'm ready now. What he bringing now? Damn, he bringing now. He a planet to shine. Up in my heart and into my mind, and I'm completely gone. Thug is my weakness, bring out my freakness. See all these niggas, but I never liked them regulars. I just never had an interest in them amateurs. Times when you're deep in, you're getting all underneath it. So you find it's not your heart. heart is your mind, it's the weakness. And maybe that is the part I'm not ready for. I'll chew your lick tonight. Show me a real good time. If that don't mean your love and protection, affection is gonna be right. Oh. He applying that pressure. He bringing that pressure.
So that was Pressure by KeKe Palmer. About that song, another dope song. It really hit me because I remember in one line she said, Thugs is my weakness, it brings out my freakness. I see all these dudes, but I never like the regulars. I'm not interested in the ones that are mature. Which really stuck out to me because... Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm doing truth time in the middle of this. This is funny. Around that time, that was me. Like, that was where I was at. Like, it wasn't that I liked the thugs. It was just, I liked the dudes that were, like, kind of bad boys and type of way. Like, you know, they got, like, that little street to them. And even though I grew up. But, you know... I understood, and then I understand that, you know, society and people put pressure on you, especially in relationships. And this song, it spoke to me in so many different ways. It definitely was a dope song, and I definitely live for it. Another song that I bumped constantly. I know my mom can attest that I bumped this a lot. We're gonna do a couple more songs and then I'm gonna give my final recap. This next song is not from the Lauren EP. It was before her EP came out. It's called Enemies and it's featuring Jeremiah. Again, like I said, this song was a total opposite from the Lauren EP in the style. Again, I thought it was a dope song. I thought the visual was amazing. Like, it actually told a story, which in the land of videos not telling stories nowadays. Believe me, check my channel and I can tell. And okay. So, in the land of videos just being pretty ass bitches and fine ass niggas just on camera, this video had a theme and a message and it had a story and I digged it. Choreography was on point. She looked amazing. She gave me the Aaliyah TLC vibes, like, which I love that she is influenced and she plays homage to these amazing artists of the past. Again, let's look at one more piece from KeKe Palmer and then I'm gonna wrap it up and I'll tell you guys what next month's artist, who's that gonna be? So This is Hands Free by my girl, KeKe Palmer, which if y'all have not seen the Hands Free video, I don't know where y'all was in 2016 because this video was lit. KeKe Palmer's Hands Free. Okay, let's talk about the video real quick. So I remember before I saw each individual video, they first released the Lauren video. It was like between 12 and 13 minutes. And it was like her music videos. It was like certain ones. There was a couple of ones that were like added into it, and it was a couple ones, you know, whatever. So when Hands Free came up, you know, she had a little speech and she was talking on the radio, and which was dope. She was speaking facts. And then when it got to the video of her, when I seen her with her Egyptian crown on with all these foreign as men crowding around her, picking her up, carrying her through the this is what I'm saying. Like, if I had a YouTube in 2016, I'm telling y'all would have lost y'all mind, because I was going the heck, and I was like, if she don't stop playing. And then she slayed me with the wine, like the dance moves, the whole choreography, the whole set. Like, she gave me remember the time. Like, she just gave me my life, and I lived for it. And that's when I was like, you know what? I stand for KeKe Palmer. She is everything. That's my girl. I live for her. So to wrap this up, I just want to say it sucks that, you know, a lot of these artists, there's a lot of dope artists out in the music industry. It sucks that a lot of them don't get the recognition and the homage and the praise that they deserve, especially when they're spending money and busting their butts, you know, going to recording studios and going to live performances and shooting music videos and putting out work. But KeKe Palmer is resilient. It has different other facets that she does with her acting and with her dancing and other stuff. And she always, one thing I have to say about KeKe Palmer is that even though her music doesn't pop as much, she finds other avenues in the industry and she excels at them. And it's just dope. It's just to see her tenacity from the little old girl from Barbershop 2 to, you know, present day. It's just dope to see her evolution. And, you know, girl, I still bop these songs to this day, because you know. But there's a couple other songs that I want you guys to listen to in your free time. Wind Up featuring Quavo, that was a dope song. The choreography for that video was amazing also. And Bossy, which she did when she was on Star. If you guys not have heard that song, Song is amazing. It goes off. So I'm gonna wrap this video up by just saying if I like this video, comment down below, hit that subscribe button, share around the world, you know, all that good jazz. Episode 2 will be out in November sometime. And body cold, frosty cold, and I'm so and I so you can do it on my girl Kalani. So be on the lookout for the next episode, which will be my girl Kalani, and we'll go through her discography and, you know, talk about her. So again, I live for every last one of you guys. I love each and every last one of you guys, and I thank you guys for watching. As usual, see you next time. Peace. Good and I'm bougie, Gucci.